Hey guys, it's Cody from IT, and today we are taking a little break from our regular Tech Tip Tuesday routine and instead are talking about the relationship between Braille displays and screen readers. We're talking about the benefits of electronic Braille and what to consider when you're first starting to use a Braille display, either for yourself or with a student. Now, of course, this is a huge topic to cover, but today we are just doing an overview of Braille displays, like this Braillient 20 or this Braillient 40X I have right here. Now, remember that these are Braille displays, not Braille note takers. Braille displays connect to an external device like a computer, a phone, or a tablet, whereas Braille note takers are their own standalone device. Now today we're going to start off by talking about why you might start to consider to use a Braille display if you're using a screen reader like JAWS, NVDA, ChromeVox, or VoiceOver for Mac. So why should we start considering a Braille display? Well, our technology setup, more than anything, should be able to serve us in a wide variety of environments, right? There's going to be times when you are either in a crowded place or you just don't have headphones, and using audio is just not going to be very feasible. But in those situations when you can't use audio, if you have a Braille display, you can just turn off your speech and use your screen reader by reading in Braille. What about if you have a lot of text to edit, right? Well, if you have a long story and you just want to read that story from top to bottom, audio is a good idea, right? But let's say you're checking the spelling of a word or making sure that all of the punctuation is correct in an essay. Well, you could do that with audio, but it's going to be a lot easier to do that in Braille, right? But let's say you're a screen reader user and you've never used a Braille display before. What should you consider before starting to use one? So there are many things that I could say about considering a new Braille display, but the main thing that I want you to know is that when you connect a Braille display to your screen reader's key commands do not change. As you're first starting out, my advice to you would be, don't stress yourself out learning all of the different new key commands that come with your Braille display's manual. You can always still just reach up to your computer keyboard and do key commands as you normally would. If your Braille display has a Perkins-style keyboard, like this Braillient 40X, you can use this keyboard to type, but don't worry about using this keyboard to control your computer. It's possible, but don't worry about it yet. Just use your regular computer keyboard. My final note to you is that remember that Braille displays are exactly what they sound like. They're just displays. Remember that you cannot effectively use a Braille display with a screen reader unless you know how to use that screen reader. Simply put, learn the screen reader before learning the Braille display. And if you're a teacher, remember that you need to teach your learner how to use a screen reader before we add that Braille display into the mix. And that's it. That's our overview of Braille displays. Now, every week this month, we are going to be coming out with a new video on electronic Braille. Next week, we're coming out with Braille note takers versus Braille displays. We're also coming out with how to access the Braille viewer in JAWS and NVDA, and how to use a Braille display like this to type in Nemeth Braille in Microsoft Word using JAWS. So lots of really great stuff coming up. You know the drill. If you want those videos, hit the subscribe button, hit the notifications button, and we'll see you next week for another Tech Tip Tuesday.